there is a rule that is ruining the NBA as we know it. If you ever seen James Harden play or just watch an NBA game before, you know the play I'm about to show you. James Harden will go up for a shot, will flail out his legs, and will get the foul call because someone stepped an inch within his landing zone. Now, I've looked up all over Google trying to find a rule on landing space in the NBA. There was a lot of Reddit, there was a lot of NBA officiating forums, but I actually had a lot of trouble finding the actual rules. But I seem to have found something from the NBA's official website saying a defensive player must allow an airborne player the opportunity to land and then stop or change direction when the offensive player is outside the lower defensive box. That is under section C of section 4, the dribble, on page 58 of the official NBA rulebook, which I will leave a link to in the comment section below. This rule is ruining the NBA. No one likes watching James Harden. Houston fans don't even like watching James Harden. But when I see James Harden or any other player go up for a three and then land with a player barely in their space, flailing and kicking their feet out, it is infuriating to watch. They are looking for the foul call. They're not even trying to make the basket. Draymond Green is known for this. James Harden is the main prospect that everybody knows for doing this. But it is a widespread epidemic that is killing the NBA. The NBA has to do something about this rule. The Zaza rule, that is fine. Zaza Pachulia is a dirty player, we all know. He purposefully undercut Kawhi Leonard. But there's a difference between what Zaza did and what other defenders do to players like James Harden. On the play with Zaza, he put his foot directly underneath Kawhi Leonard. He did not put his foot near Kawhi Leonard, and Kawhi Leonard did not kick his feet out. Zaza didn't let Kawhi land in his own spot. And I know you're saying that's the rule they have in place. But the difference is that James Harden and these players are purposefully leaning in and kicking out to draw the contact. If the offensive player initiates his contact, they should not be allowed to get the foul call. I mean, I've seen this so many times, and there have been so many questionable calls. Every playoffs, what do we hear from the Rockets? The officiating screwed us over. What happened this season? James Harden, the Rockets, Mike D'Antoni, the officiating screwed us over. They had the Warriors without Kevin Durant, Chris Paul was healthy, they still couldn't do it. This rule that makes James Harden one of the better players in the entire NBA. James Harden would not average 30 points a game if they didn't call these fouls. He would still be one of the best players in the NBA, don't get me wrong. But this rule is one of the biggest reasons why he is as good as he is. He is able to manipulate the rules perfectly. And I give him a lot of credit for that. To be able to understand the minutia of a rule like that and be able to exploit it perfectly to get every single foul call, but then to not even try and make the basket. It's just, as an NBA fan, a person who's been watching basketball for years now, it is so painful to watch the Houston Rockets and these other players play and flail around like ragdolls. It's ridiculous. If one of my players, if I was coaching and one of my players did that, I mean, I don't know what I would do. It's just, it's cheap, it's unnecessary, and the NBA is making each of its games longer, less interesting, and less fun by having this rule implemented. They need to adjust the officiating. Now, the rule is bad enough, but as I said to you already, the rule is pretty simple. You have to allow the airborne player the opportunity to land and then stop or change direction when the offensive player is outside the lower defensive box. The officials need to change the way they call these fouls. You can't bail someone out. If they flail their arms out, if they flail their legs out, and they initiate contact, they should not get the foul call. Listen, I do not envy these refs whatsoever. The NBA officials had the no-win job in this scenario. There is no positives to being an official in today's NBA. You get yelled at on either side, and I have to give every single referee a ton of credit, because throughout the entirety of a 48-minute game, we focus on the one call that they miss and not the 250 others that they made correctly. This is not on the officials. It's the way they're taught, and the NBA needs to do something, unless these players are going to keep doing this kicking and this yelling and this complaining. It's getting out of hand, and we need to do something about it. I will be back, and hopefully by then, the NBA will have done something to adjust for this rule. Guys, let me know what you think of this in the comment section below. I'd love to hear what you think about the landing rule. I'll be sure to leave a link to the official rule book and the section that I found that quote from. I'll leave that in the comment section below. Be sure to subscribe. I'm coming out with a lot more videos soon. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.